The Animal Welfare League on Sydney's Western Fringe is the home of second chances.
She's a little Australian terrier mix.
I don't even know what that is.
Here, dedicated staff and volunteers match the orphaned and abandoned with their forever families.
Hi.
Oh, hello. Can't believe there's a crime.
And while sometimes it's a miss, there's no mistaking true love when it's gone. Straight to the heart.
My beautiful boy.
I love you.
Can I take you home?
Every new day at the Animal Welfare League.
Good girl.
Represents a new opportunity for the dogs that arrive.
Hi, how are you going? So here we have Hayley.
Hayley!
Yeah.
So why is she here?
She transferred to us from a regional facility. As you can see, she's taking it quite well, actually.
Yeah.
She's not quite as nervous as a lot of the guys we get come through.
Oh, honey.
You're
Do you know
so
of any, I guess, behavioural issues? Has anyone said anything?
No, the information that we got from... as we can see... Where are you going?
Okay, bye, Hayley.
Okay, we might just let her do her thing.
Good.
Very motivated by the looks of it.
What are your thoughts? My original thoughts are she will be fine to rehome.
Oh, I don't
quite
think
easy. We'll,
from the history that we've got, you know, dog social, people social.
I can't believe we've got a blue and white Staffy. She's calm. She walks well on lead. Super food motivated.
She's ticking all the boxes.
I think this is the day of my life.
Oh, really?
I wouldn't swap anything for this.
Sue and Martin are hoping to adopt a four-legged sibling for their 8-year-old daughter, Scarlett.
Even if humans did all the things dogs do, it wouldn't be cute.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
A human licking someone's face. Gross. Sniffing someone else's butt. Not cute.
How old are you?
I'm 8.
8?
I'm not too young, but I'm not too old.
What's too old?
Like an adult. I don't want to be
an adult. Yeah, an adult, do you?
I call Scarlett the Oracle because some of the stuff that comes out of her mouth occasionally just makes our jaws drop with insight.
Am I too old?
Yo. My dad, he doesn't have dad jokes, he has bad jokes.
Oh.
My mum is the more responsible one.
Just imagine our dog might be just sitting out there in its kennel, not knowing what's happening, going to be happening to it today.
Probably thinking, I wouldn't mind meeting a curly-haired girl today.
A curly-haired girl that bakes doggy treats.
Feeds me well.
Hello.
Hi.
My name is Juliet.
Hi.
I'm Nick.
So why now for a dog, guys?
I think Scarlett's just at that perfect age. She's shown with our four fish that she can be quite responsible in feeding and sort of looking after them, and she just loves dogs.
I think definitely dogs are better than siblings because siblings can annoy you, they can stay with things. Dogs, they don't even talk and they're fluffy. Siblings aren't fluffy.
And what do you do for work?
I'm an architect.
You're an architect. And Sue?
I run my and safety consultancy at home.
Okay.
From home.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
Matt and I met 12 years ago doing a personal development course around communication, which is interesting.
So something between the lines there?
No, just, you know. Yeah.
So what does the dream dog look like, guys?
I like big dogs.
Awesome.
Yep.
And team big dog.
I think we've got a lot of kids in our life. Obviously,
yep.
Scarlett being the most
yep.
important one, but her friends and other friends and
customers.
Things.
We have lots of dogs in our neighbourhood.
We have lots of dogs in our neighbourhood, so they need to be
and in our life.
Social dog that's probably a bit sporty.
Yeah,
we're pretty active.
I was going to ask, is Jumpy a deal breaker?
As long as it's a trainable issue, I think Scarlett will have the ultimate say. You know, she's got to feel comfortable around whatever dog we get.
I think we've got a lot of information to work off, so we are going to go look and see what we've got and try to find that perfect dog for you guys.
Great.
Thank you very much.
All
nose.
My nose.
Very more excited than I was.
Yeah, more excited. I didn't think you could be more excited.
Yeah, I didn't think I could be either.
Got a lovely family out there today.
Nice family, yeah?
Really lovely. Scarlett is going, I want a big dog.
Well, that's good to hear. It's all kind of breeze there like that.
Look, they seem pretty open to pretty much everything. We've got a lot of potentials for them. What about Chicky? She's a lovely dog.
She's really sweet. Look at that little face.
She's toilet trained, walks well on a leash. Dog avoidant, but should be good with kids.
She's not dog social. I say dog avoidant, but she also, if the dog isn't a face, she does snap.
I think
is the right fit for them.
Yeah.
We do have another option in Rusty.
I love Rusty.
Oh, yeah. So cute.
Look at
So he's only young still. He's only just over here.
Yeah.
Kelpie, obviously, he's very active.
So he's a gigantic kisser, licks everyone he meets, gentle soul, ecstatic about meeting other dogs and people. He's a very good option.
He's a very good option.
Yeah.
Do we have a team, Rusty?
I think Rusty's a go.
Definitely Rusty. Yep. Just have to make sure they can handle his activity. Hey, guys.
Hi.
We think we've come up with a really great option for you.
Cool.
His name is Rusty.
Rusty.
Nice name.
Really social in all aspects of his life. Really loves kids. Really loves people. Really loves dogs.
Awesome. And he's a red Kelpie cross.
Yeah. I don't know what that looks like, but...
You don't know what that looks like? Are you Australian or not?
Have you seen Red Dog?
Red Dog. Okay. Yeah.
He's only a year and a half, so he is...
Still in that energetic stage.
Yep.
Great.
So you seem quite... excited about a working dream.
I love cattle dogs and Kelpies.
Team cattle dogs.
And just the ability to train
team
them.
Yeah,
the fact they are so smart.
So, who would like to meet Rusty?
Yes.
Please. All right, guys.
Okay.
Let's
show you the way. Hi, sweetheart.
Are you excited to go?
Rusty had an older owner who unfortunately couldn't take care of him anymore.
Let's go!
He does obviously have a lot of needs. He's a very active dog, and they were just struggling a little bit to properly care for him. So he came to us. Being high energy and being very playful, anyone looking to adopt Rusty with children would just need to be aware that he probably is going to be jumpy when he's excited, especially when first meeting people. It's definitely something that can be managed. Rusty is highly intelligent and he loves to give you kisses, so expect lots and lots of licks from Rusty. Yes. Good timing.
Yeah, I think they called him Rusty because he's red.
Yeah. What if he has red eyes?
We met a little bit late, took us a while to find each other.
Yeah.
It was great when we did, but it did take us a little while. And so I guess we were very lucky to be able to have Scarlett. We were just so fortunate.
Actually, Scarlett.
We would have loved to have given her a sibling, but that wasn't written in the stars for us.
We might be able to see the shadows with
it. I know, are you looking at
that? Under the door.
There's almost no other choice. If I was to get a dog, this is the, like, I would only get a rescue dog. And even in the future, if we get another dog, it would always be a rescue, I think. Giving them, that second chance.
Do you think they'll just run and jump
into the water? I don't know. I'm adopted and I've always known since I was forever. And have a beautiful, loving, adopted family. But I guess, you know, when you're adopted, you do grow up feeling like you perhaps don't belong or just not sure what your place is in the world. And I used to, when I was younger, I used to think that was the story, being given up for adoption. But it's just not, because life is love, it's family, it's friends, it's finding your own place to belong. And it is part of my story, but it's not the story.
Good boy. Yes, good boy.
Whether it's humans or animals down on their luck, they absolutely deserve to belong and they deserve a second chance, much like I had. Yeah.
Billy there? Are you excited?
He's so handsome. Look at him.
Such a good looking dog.
Here he comes.
Come on, ready?
His legs.
Here you go.
In the meeting pen, 8-year-old Scarlet is about to meet a playmate like no other in Rusty, the red Kelpie cross.
Good boy. Come on. Ready? Ready? Here you go.
Oh my God, I thought she was going to cry then for a sec.
This is Rusty.
He'll probably run around here and have a sniff and have a play. Rusty.
Sorry.
Rusty.
What? Do you feel comfy?
Good.
He's very energetic and very excitable.
Hi.
He loves kisses as well.
You're right. You're right. Hello.
Oh, how cute. He's having a dime of his life, Rusty.
Now that he's calmed down a bit, are you okay for me to take him off lead?
Yeah.
So just remember, if he does try and jump up, just try and stay calm and just turn away from him rather than jumping.
Yeah.
Rusty. 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 Sit. Rusty.
Sit down.
Sit.
He's just excited. Sit. Good girl. Drop it.
Rusty.
It's okay. Just hold yourself.
Just turn around. Come here.
Hold yourself. Okay. Come here.
Whoa.
Come here.
What happened? You're a bit scared.
Okay.
You're a bit scared.
Scratchy. Okay.
First doing excitement. So she's talking about Rusty. Super social. Yeah. If you want to say hello, he's just jumping
that's
up.
Right, yeah.
But also, if you're not used to the bigger dog jumping, you can scare you a little bit for a child.
He's a bit full on, isn't he?
Okay. Just really excited. Okay.
I think Mum understands Rusty, and Rusty is what she expected. Yeah. I think she's very on board with his play style and activity levels.
Good boy. Good boy.
By the looks of it, Scarlett's not super keen.
I think he wants to check that you're okay. You want to give him a little pat underneath? He's wondering why you're not. It's okay.
It's a bit much for you.
It's okay. It's all okay.
She just keeps crying.
Yeah, I don't think this is going to work.
You're afraid of him. Okay.
Yeah. So if you're scared of him, then he's not the dog for us, okay?
Yeah, let's get Rusty out of there. I think Scarlett's looking a bit too upset now.
Today's certainly been a bit of a roller coaster.
I'm just going to take him outside for you guys.
See you, Rusty.
Bye, Rusty. Come on.
Good boy.
He was really emotional. Because he really wanted to have that sort of fairy tale story of adopting. And I guess it made me sort of feel, and I guess having a family of my own, we all do belong. And so,
graphic designer Elaine has come to AWL in search of a companion for her city lifestyle.
Any single time that I've been around the presence of dogs and dog sitting or dating someone that has a dog, I think my life is just so much happier.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm Elaine.
Elaine, welcome.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm definitely feeling nervous. Mm. Just a little bit.
I was assuming first dog ever. You never had a dog.
I've never owned a dog, no.
Oh, okay. So were you the creepy person that just everyone else's dog?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
So I like to stop being that creepy.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, you've had like, who's going to cuddle me on the couch? Like, there's moments where, like, at home, you hold your cushion. I'm like, this could be a dog. I want it to be a dog, not a cushion. It's going to give me some love back.
Can I just say, though, your outfit? It's like chic.
Like, I'm willing to ruin the skirt for a dog, so.
I get you.
In the meeting pen, Rusty the Red Kelpie has been removed after an overly energetic encounter with 8-year-old Scarlet.
We have people that come through our doors who realise afterwards they've met the dog and going, oh, this is actually a bit too much. That's when we have to change things around, going, all right, well, we know now what you actually want and what we can actually provide for you with the dog. Rusty, as much as he's a great dog and he's full of energy and he's a perfect fit for them, but obviously a bit too much for Scarlet, and she obviously got a bit worried. So we do have Lightning. I think the good thing with Lightning is that he has been in the house with other kids, so obviously Lightning will be good around with Scarlet.
That's right.
He's really active.
Oh, that's good. Yep.
Likes dogs. Obviously, we didn't go with Lightning originally just because of he's a bit of a small dog and they were looking for more of a large. But I think after seeing Rusty's being great, I think maybe a smaller dog is probably a bit better.
What's more suited to them.
Yeah.
All we can do is put it to them and see what they think.
Yeah.
Hi, baby.
Pick up a little walkie.
Lightning is a very energetic little boy.
Let's go.
He can be a bit jumpy, but he's super small, so it doesn't really matter. Kissy, come on. He was surrendered to our Soulhaven branch. His family really, really loved him, and they really didn't want to surrender him, but unfortunately, they were allergic. For anyone that's ever wanted a Kelpie and wanted that energy and that personality, but just wanted it in a smaller body, Lightning is perfect.
How are you feeling right now?
Impatient.
I think Scarlet will embrace having a dog. She will also, I think, at times feel that it's not just about her anymore.
How long will it?
I don't know. She'll have to get used to just,
not being the focus of our one and only love focus.
Sharing the love.
Yeah.
Good boy. You got meeting your family? Hey, maybe you go home.
Second time lucky?
Yes.
There we go.
Indeed. Lucky Lightning.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. So he might just have a bit of a sniff around. He will come to you in time. Might be good for you guys to get a bit lower just because he is so small as well, and you don't want to be too intimidating for him or anything like that. If you guys are comfortable, I'll just be outside the door.
Yeah, right.
Yep. Perfect.
Lightning. He's sniffing the pillow.
You think he's cute?
Yeah. Lightning.
This is totally different to Rusty because he's more independent, doing my own thing, sniffing around,
like the opposite.
And Scarlet wants Lightning to come over.
I don't know. Lightning.
Just be patient, love. It can take some time.
Sometimes the children really want that connection straight away and they want the dogs to come straight away and they just don't understand that these dogs I've gone through something and it's a new environment, so it's about giving him a chance in the home and he will build a bond pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Are you worried he's not going to come to you?
No.
What are you worried about?
Talk to me. It doesn't feel right. Okay.
I guess for an 8-year-old who doesn't have a lot of experience of her own with her own dogs in the home, it would be hard for her to understand what Lightning is going through.
Take the chicken because that's what he likes.
Okay, I'll do
Lightning.
Underneath. Oh, good boy.
Hi.
Look at the chicken here. Oh, you know where that is.
Hello, friend.
Come on.
He's got the tail wagging. Oh, he's pretty comfortable.
Yes. A much better match for Scarlet, for sure.
Yeah, she's a lot more calm. And Mum and Dad seem pretty happy as well.
Yeah.
Aww.
Oh, you're hungry, are you?
Hi.
How's it going?
It's good.
Hello, baby. Hello. How would you feel about taking him for a walk?
Yeah?
All right, perfect.
I was actually hoping that there would be instant connection and it would be really easy to see, but but it's actually not.
Do you wanna?
Okay.
No?
I feel like I've been a bit fussy with the dog.
You just felt how you felt?
This is the dog that we're probably gonna have forever, so it has to be perfect.
You gotta be fussy. Yeah.
Awesome. Currently, I live in a one-bedroom apartment in the city, but it does get lonely.
Okay, so your living situation at the moment, you said you're on your own, there's no partners or kids or anything like that?
No, nothing, just me and my house plants.
Yep, me and my plants. I like that.
Sounds like me. When I got married, I was 22 years old. I was living kind of like my dream. I had my dream guy. It was my first love, but unfortunately, it didn't quite work out, so it was only a year that we were married. Officially divorced around 24.
So your ideal dog, what would that be for you?
I love big dogs, but unfortunately I don't have a living space that can have a big dog. So any type of medium dog would be amazing.
Just imagining you've got like a giant property, what are your dream breeds?
I really do love the nature of like border collies because they're just so fun and smart.
Sure.
They're very active though, and I'm a really introverted person when I'm at home, so definitely a dog that tires out and needs to like sleep at home would be amazing.
It kind of sounds like you're not too interested in the breed, more the temperament and the fit.
I am. I think that's a really good way of saying it's more the temperament of the dog.
Yeah.
Even if I don't like the breed, to be honest, I'll just be like, oh, you love me so much more than a human. I love you already.
That's true. Do you have a certain age bracket?
I think I'd take one up to like 10 years old.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's given us lots to think about.
Yeah, definitely.
We might go have a chat with our manager and see who we can come up with. So leave it with us.
Thank you.
First time dog owner in an apartment. She lives completely on her own and she wants a dog that she can curl up and cuddle with. Yeah. So she just wants a friend.
Little Banksy.
Breed wise, I don't know what he is, but he's got like a sausage body with a Staffy head, so but like funny. A Jack Russell temperament. Absolute pocket rocket.
Dog's great with people, ticks a lot of boxes, but I just think that he's probably a bit too energetic for the apartment. He's very close, but not quite the one.
Okay.
So I think we've got Hayley.
Hayley! She's such a pretty girl.
So cute.
And she's not a high energy Staffy
she's
either.
Not,
she's not
going to
bang around her apartment or anything.
The good thing about Hayley is that she's got no separation anxiety. She is actually a bit of a couch potato when she goes home.
Okay, so she's a great option.
It's a pretty good choice. I think she's the right for Elaine.
Great.
Thank you.
All right.
Good to get her home.
Hayley! We think we have found you the right pooch.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So she's nearly three. Her name is Hayley. She is a blue and white Staffy.
Beautiful.
Yeah. She's this beautiful mix of cuddly, but then also loves going out on adventures. For a first-time dog owner, she is awesome.
I need to meet her.
Yeah.
How we met.
Great. Okay, let's get this started then, shall we? Hi, Hayley.
Are you excited?
Let's go.
Good girl.
Hayley is about 3 years old, and she is a blue Staffy cross. She's a very, very chilled Staffy, which is why I say that she is a very rare Staffy find. Good girl, Hayley. Good work. I definitely think Hayley's the ultimate companion. She's
knows when you're in a mood that you need a big kiss. She knows when to be a bit excited and show you that she loves you. So I think she's just absolutely perfect.
When I lost my marriage, I just felt like there was nothing that was truly mine that was left, that was part of this happy ending that I thought I was going to get. I didn't think I was going to be divorced at 24. It took a few years to even reflect and be calm and know that my story still will be able to go on, that it's okay that it's not written in the traditional way or the way that you thought it was going to be. Divorcees always get labeled as like little hermits and like can't talk about it, it's awkward, or they're really like angry and all that stuff. I'm like, it's made me stronger more than anything.
Feel like I'm going on a blind date.
I'm so ready for a bit of love. Perhaps a human companion in the future, but a four-legged one.
This can be your new friend.
I'm getting nervous. I'm so excited. Don't know.
Kind of a big moment, isn't it? She's been waiting for a dog literally her whole entire life, so no pressure, but I'm really happy this goes well.
Here it is. Moment of truth.
Ready?
Good girl.
Hi. This is Hayley.
Hi.
As you can see, she loves to sniff. So she will take a while and just have a little bit of a sniff, but she does love people, so she will love a big cuddle.
Awesome.
Good girl. She's so
beautiful. Say hello.
Hi, Hayley.
Hi.
Oh. Are you happy for me to let her off?
Yeah, go for it.
Perfect. Hey. Pretty. I could so see them walking around the city together. Like, they actually, like, look really good together.
Two strong, independent women.
You ready? Do you want to play some ball? You want to go?
Wrong way!
Ball,
get it!
Can I get it? Okay.
Do you actually play fetch?
Fetch?
No fetch.
I think Elaine's feeling a little bit rejected, you know?
Yeah. This is so important for her. She's been waiting literally her entire life for a dog. I mean, you know how it is when you're all alone, and you, I mean, your animals, you rely on them so much for your company and for your love.
Hayley!
She doesn't like you, but she just likes to do her own thing as well.
Yeah. Hayley!
Feel sorry for her.
Loving couple Dale and Peter are looking to create a family with the addition of a rescue dog.
We met online about 4 years ago.
I remember that first date too. I was like, hey, you're hot.
Yes.
Good morning.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome to AWL. You guys are a lovely, good looking pair.
Absolutely. For me, it feels like we're going through this process with the dog as well, which is like very, very cool.
Well, guys, feel free to take a seat.
Thanks so much. Pete and I have had great success on the dating app, so why on earth would this not work?
All
right. There's our dog.
Oh, what do you like to play?
Do you like tug-of-war?
Elaine is trying to form a friendship, but Hayley the Staffy is not playing ball.
I guess to Elaine it might look like Hayley's not too interested in her.
Hayley!
But to us, Hayley's got that beautiful loose body, that waggy tail, and this is Hayley. She's a love bug, but then can also be that independent girl we know.
Yeah, I think this is actually a good match. Hopefully Elaine feels that too.
Bumps.
Yeah, Elaine's trying really hard. She really wants Hayley to be with her, like, all the time.
Oh, no, ball first. Bubble.
good enough for now.
Oh, this is nice.
Oh, that's so cute.
Come on. Now we're getting somewhere.
Oh,
my God.
I'm going to get
you. Okay.
Hi. Hello, baby. Hello. How you been going?
All right.
Yeah.
How about?
So, do you want to take her for a walk?
Sure.
Yeah, perfect. Let's go. Oh, you're a bit strong, sweetheart. Yes. You're good. All right, so what do you think?
Good little match they are. They're a very pretty couple, aren't they? My only concern is that I feel like, is Hayley not affectionate enough for Elaine?
I think I'm 50-50 on her at the moment.
Oh, you walk faster than I do.
She's still a little bit of an excited Staffy in her side, but I think she has the nature to be really calm as well. I can't answer if there's a future yet. I will need that second date.
Good morning. Hi.
Good morning.
And what are we doing here today?
Finding a dog, hopefully.
Yeah. You're in a good place for that. We'll have a couple.
Well, what do you guys do for work?
So I'm a mortgage broker and help people kind of get their finances together and help them get into their first homes a lot of the time. I know mortgage broking does sound boring. I'm one of those nerds that really enjoys it.
And I'm a dance choreographer.
Oh.
So let's be honest. I'm a choreographer, but he likes to give me dance moves. And I'm like, yeah, we'll take that one on board.
That's all I need. Just a little bit of encouragement and I'm good.
Oh, a lot, yeah.
Why are we after a dog today?
We're just at that moment, aren't we? We're ready, you know. We just finished renovating our house and we've kind of got it all set up now.
Great.
And just ready to add to the family.
Yeah, no children in this lifetime, I think. It's an age thing. In a different universe, you know, would have had children, and I think Pete would have been a brilliant dad.
Yeah, the furry friend is the next step for us. So we want to try and take it to work as much as we can.
Yes.
Because we both have our own businesses, but there's going to be numerous days that we can't.
Okay.
So a dog that's kind of happy 5-6 hours by itself.
Okay. Sure.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah. And what does that sort of dream dog look like?
Yeah, well, we're thinking medium to small.
Okay.
Probably so mostly for the size of the backyard. Yeah.
And probably not the miniature.
So like Staffy size, I guess?
Yeah, something like that.
Okay,
How about deal breakers?
We might be challenged a little bit because we're not that experienced. We both had, you know, dogs as kids growing up in our families.
Yeah.
But it's been, you know, since leaving home till now, which is quite a few decades in between.
And breed, are there big no-no breeds that you're like, nope, I don't want that one, or you're sort of open to see who's here?
Most breeds were...
Yeah,
it's all about the personality, isn't it? And whether they like us and we like them.
Yeah, that's a lot of options. So we've got lots to chat about.
Yeah,
oh, cool.
Brilliant. Yeah.
So we'll head back. We'll have a chat. Come back out to you guys soon.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Great.
Tell me about this couple.
So we have Pete and Dale.
They were open to all breeds. They're more after what's inside than what's on the outside.
That's right. Okay, cool. Yeah. That's good.
And I think a dog potentially without a lot of separation anxiety, just because they do like to take it to work, but they said there are going to be times, days potentially, where the dog will be left alone.
Yeah. They're not super experienced in dog training, so anything like severe separation anxiety and things like that, they're not quite sure how to manage. I was thinking Barney.
I love this greyhound.
Yeah.
Just over 1 year, so he's in their age range. He loves his squeakers and his tennis balls. He loves doing his zoomies, typical greyhound.
Yeah.
And he's a water dog, so he loves his shovel.
Yeah, that's so funny.
Yeah. Bit big?
Yeah, it was a bit too big.
So we've got Tess. Tess is just under 5.5 years old. She can be quite an excitable little thing.
I like when you open up that doggy door. She runs straight up to you and she jumps up. How do you have a bad day when she's that excited to see you?
She has a little bit of separation anxiety, but nothing major.
Tess has been here for quite a while. She's been here for over 3 months now, so it's quite a long time. Poor little thing.
Oh, so skinny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's come a very long way. I love the fact that, you know, we've managed to help her come from what she was, really skinny, to where she is now. I think that's a really good thing.
Yeah, and they're always so sweet. They come from the worst background. They always end up
always the way, isn't it?
I know.
Yeah. I really like Tess for these guys.
I think she's a great match. Yeah, I think she's a good option.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, Tess it is.
Yay!
I'm starting to get a bit nervous.
Me too. Hello.
Hi.
Oh.
Hi.
All right. We think we found you somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
She is 5, mm-hmm. and her name is Tess.
Yeah.
She's so great for someone that hasn't got a lot of dog experience because she does walk quite nicely on lead.
She's confident, so she'll be able to deal, I guess, with the changing if you decide to take her in the car, go to the office.
Okay.
She will be able to cope relatively well once she's set into a routine in your home.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you'd like to meet her?
Oh, yeah, yes. Definitely.
Follow us.
Go, guys.
Yay. Hello, honey.
This is Tess. She's a Staffy Kelpie mix.
Let's go.
So when Tess came into our care, she was quite neglected. So just seeing her gain her confidence and just be a bit more out of her shell is really nice. What I love about Tess is she's a really sweet, active girl, and she's just a big ball of love.
Do we run?
Yes, can we get there? It is ridiculously nice to be in love.
Yay.
Yes.
It's yellow door.
Yellow door. And at this age, like I say this age, you know, I'm nearly 50, so to have this sense of love, like, it's beautiful. I'm literally trying to think the last time I felt this nervous and excited. Like, it's not bad nervous. It's
when you met me.
Oh, yeah, probably.
Yeah. No, second date, because then you knew me.
Yeah.
No.
No, not at all. I was very excited. I think I was early on the second date, too.
You were?
Yeah, you were late.
I was on time. You classed it as late.
Because I was early.
She is amazing. You just give. You give so much. You do make me be a better person. Who would have thought we'd be here? Waiting for a dog.
Well, you wouldn't want to talk of that at the same day, would you? I never really wanted love to come quickly. I wanted it to come beautifully. Everything that I've got now, I was waiting for that. I would wait another 10 or 15 years if that needed to be the case with the dog. I mean, you can't force it.
It's got to be a connection. And also, you know, if we really like the dog and doesn't seem to be bonding with you, we'd rather wait.
Tess.
Somebody at the door.
Oh, my Lord. Oh my goodness. It's real.
Partners Dale and Peter are hoping for a spark in the meeting pen with Tess.
Somebody at the door.
Ah, oh, somebody at the door. Oh, my God.
Oh, look at those little feet. Oh, my Lord. Look at that.
Oh, it's beautiful.
So this is beautiful little Tess.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, Tess. She's very excited at the moment.
Yeah.
Let her get out her zoomies and then just approach her and let her come up to you.
Okay.
You mind if I take her off lead?
No, fine. Should we get down lower or should we...
You guys are fine where you are. And then if you're comfortable, you can come down to her when she starts to settle down a little bit.
Oh, she's gorgeous.
If you guys are comfortable, I'll just be outside.
Oh,
gorgeous.
Hello. How good is she? It's like a tree.
Yeah, no, we're off.
Wait.
She has beautiful eyes.
Yeah.
My God, it's like love at first sight to look at her.
Isn't it? It's emotional.
Me too. I was quite emotional. I got quite teary.
No.
Oh, that's cute. They're both emotional.
So we'll just give her a minute.
Yeah, we're like chill.
Okay.
Even though we're desperate.
They want so much to just jump off there and hug Tess. They're like busting at the seams.
They just have so much love to give.
Hello.
Oh my gosh, you're beautiful.
Hello.
Oh,
oh, she came when they called her.
It's like a tree.
Is it a tree? Oh, well, she's a bit scared, isn't she? Look at that tail tuck.
She's a bit timid.
A little bit concerned.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful.
sorry. Got a little bit scared there for a minute.
Oh, she's fast. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm a little bit surprised at that.
I'm not. She does go through these sort of phases of being timid. And I guess, you know, new people, she might be a bit timid.
Yeah.
Different things can trigger a trauma response in dogs. Unfortunately, we don't always have the full background of what has happened to the animal before they arrive to the shelter. We do have the odd occasion where they have been hurt by people before, whether that be physically or with words. And, you know, raising your voice in a certain way or moving too suddenly can trigger that sort of that fear response.
That tail to pop up, don't we, so we feel happy.
Gotta stop patting like ASAP.
Sam's around?
Yeah. Oh, she's uncomfortable.
Tess is looking a little bit stiff. Can you just please go into the pen? She went really tight there.
She did.
She's actually gonna bite.
Yep.
Hi, how's everything going?
Good.
Yeah, she's,
hi. She definitely wants you.
You can tell that she's nervous. Hi.
Yeah, she is a little bit, and a little bit with touch as well.
Yeah.
So don't touch her too much?
If you're just to pat her, just give her a few seconds to pat, and then just remove. She will get more comfortable with you as well, so the more she gets to know you, and the more you guys sort of bond as well. And I don't think she quite knows how to approach people as well, so that would be something that you guys would just have to work on.
These dogs have had a bit of trauma.
Yeah.
And they need someone to understand they're not going to come bouncing up perfectly.
Do you have some toys?
Hey.
What is
that? Oh, what's
that? That's a fluffy.
Not quite ready yet. Oh, a bit scared of that one.
Some dogs that come to us have never even seen a ball, wouldn't even know what to do with a ball, which is really sad. But she will pick it up.
It's a roll. Process, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you can't just expect them just to go, you're good.
They're very understanding. A lot of families we have would come in and they would automatically be like, their dog doesn't like me.
That's right. Or they think it's too much work.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's just give it a little bit of time and you'll reap the rewards for
them. Yeah. I guess the question is, are they prepared to
put that leap of faith? Yeah.
She seems really nice natured.
Yeah.
Like the way she was coming up to us at times. But, yeah, whether she trusts us or not is entirely up to her. We can't control that.
Sorry.
Just a couple.
Yeah. You're okay.
So that is a consideration we're going to have to make on whether we are the right personalities. She ends up coming home with us. There is a bit of work to do around her trust issues and feeling comfortable in the space.
Hey, Tess, it's okay. It's okay.
As a family, adopting a dog is a fairly big decision because, as far as we're concerned, it's another member of the family.
Yes. Oh, my God, you always win!
I was lukewarm on Lightning because I wasn't quite sure whether he was going to be the interactive dog that I know Scarlett wanted.
I had a few concerns that there wasn't that initial connection.
Oh, Lightning!
Lightning! Come here!
We've decided to bring Lightning into our family.
Come here, boy.
Good boy.
Good boy. Good boy.
Having Lightning at home, it's been great to give him a second chance and another loving home.
Lightning, sit. I've been feeding him, playing with him. I've taken him for a walk with just me.
Good boy. Scarlett has stepped up amazingly.
Good boy. Draw.
She's been really great at training, does little tricks and training with him, and spends a lot of time with him. I've been really proud of her, actually.
Not a big deal. I feel like he's just my half little brother.
Do you love him yet?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Time for one.
Meeting Tess, we fell in love with the look of her and her energy. I was just like, wow. And then it was like, oh, all right.
You could tell that she was a little bit nervous of us. She was a little bit worried about us.
You know, you just want them to find that connection with you and you with them. That didn't happen for us.
We had a number of concerns. Yeah, whether we were going to take Tess home or not.
Tess!
But decided that those concerns just weren't worth worrying about.
Hello! Hello, beautiful!
She came to live with us and she's been fantastic since. Good girl. Our life has changed dramatically.
Hey, gorgeous girl. Yeah. There we go.
We didn't realise how much love Tess would bring into our life.
Yeah. Am I going to give it to Dad?
She's just added the new dimension.
We hang out together as a unit so much more, but now it's like this family feel to it.
You've become that third family member, child, and just the final piece of the puzzle.
Where are you? Gotcha. Yes.
My standing in the house has gone down a notch, but I'm okay with that. So I'm happy to be number three.
Hey.
What are you doing?
When Hayley popped out, I definitely was a little bit shocked at her size. I was adamant on giving her a try. For a while, I realized that I wasn't quite ready to take on, as a first-time pet owner, such a large companion. There were many tears involved in bringing her back to the shelter, as it felt a little bit like I failed her. But I still really wanted a fluffy companion in my life, so I went back to AWL and ta-da! This is Polarator, or Polar for short. It is so precious coming home to a fluffy, cute face every day. Having a cat can be frustrating, especially when they're a kitten. It's like having a toddler. But you look at the cute little face and you can't really stay mad for too long.
Polaroid, Polaroid, come on, up, 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 baby, up.
I did not expect to come home with the cat.